not what the Nation of Islam does. It's trained soldiers to effectively engage in this race war. First, by getting our mind right. By which I mean, we have a clear perspective on the two sides of the war. The person who asked that question, the reason they don't know that they are currently the victim of a race war, an existing race war, is because they probably don't know that the white man is the devil and the enemy of the black man. So that person don't know who his or her enemy is. This is why they don't know that they are engaged in a war. We teach the knowledge of self, the knowledge of God, and the knowledge of other than self, meaning our enemy. So first, the Nation of Islam gets our mind right. Then it trains us for battle first by changing our behavior so that on the battlefield, we are successful. I'm sorry. If I give you an example of military training. When we, the Nation of Islam, observe our national fast, the first weekend of every month, that is actually military training, sir. Because on a battlefield, black folks who eat three meals a day and snacks in between, we think we have to eat. And so when fighting breaks out, our dependence on food, our dependence on our appetite, our hunger, will make us betray our brothers and sisters. We have to be trained so that we don't need food for a week, for 2 weeks. So we as men will never be tempted when resources are scarce. We won't be tempted to take food out of our wife's mouth, out of our children's mouth. No, we can go without eating that. But unless we are trained in the science and discipline of fasting, we are a liability on the battlefield because Satan controls the resources. If we are a victim of this weaponized weed, you know the point of the weaponized weed? I said that the program that produced it, the U.S. Army Chemical Corps program that produced the weaponized weed, it was titled Conquer by Cannabis Operation. By conquering by cannabis, the weaponized weed, when it was first produced in the lab, they tested it on dogs. And they knew they were successful when the dog, despite having his paws stepped on, despite having his body beat and abused, that canine or those canines that have been exposed to that weaponized weed will not respond violently to the abuse. And so the weaponized weed demilitarizes the black man and woman. We are high. And we suffer all this abuse, but we are never compelled to do anything beyond getting in a prayer circle or protesting next to white people. We have been totally demilitarized. So we need you, brothers and sisters, to put that blunt down because it demilitarizes. So we in the Nation of Islam, we get training that's predicated upon a discipline, a lifestyle that is necessary for success on the battlefield.